Yeah, so we've talked about refresh rate, frame buffer, right? And we have also seen that for different types of images, for different types of systems, how many bits are required to store every pixel, and how will you represent each pixel in case of color system. Right, for RGB, 8 bits for each, 24 bits. We have talked about that is what is called as true color representation, and we have solved few problems related to refresh rate, frame buffer, and all what we have discussed. We have talked about something called as RGB, a model, right? So let me pressure my screen. Yeah, please check whether it is visible or not. Okay, Nitesh, thank you. Okay, thank you. Hold. So if you can remember, we have talked about something called as RGB models, so with different values for like red, green, and blue. We have talked about the RGB color space. If there are three different things here, one is R, one is G, and one is B, three different components. If one bit is switched on means if I put the value as one and the other says zero, so then we'll get something called as a red color over here. So similarly, we have also seen that RGB color model is an additive process. We have seen if you add red plus green and blue plus green plus red plus blue, you'll get different colors like magenta and cyan and yellow. And we've also seen that basically we have seen the 3-bit code system, and within this or using this 3-bit code system, we were able to achieve 8 colors, right? So that's why then we have talked about something called as CMY, RGB models. Basically, in display monitors, we use RGB model because it is what is called as a true color representation. And the CMY is basically used in printers, right? So that's what also we have talked about. Yeah. The last part, what we were discussing yesterday, is nothing but direct coding, right? So direct coding, basically. Image representation basically is, we all know that image is nothing but a representation of different pixels and pixels. When you talk about pixels, means it will have two different things. One is intensity, the color values, and one is the coordinate values, right? So how will you code the pixels, every pixels, into different colors? So that is what is called as direct coding. And for example, we have taken the 8 different colors what we have generated using this RGB space using 3 different bits. So similarly, if you are talking about color images, so definitely there will be 3 different components for red, green, and blue, and every component will have 8 bits of memory requirement. And accordingly, we know that if it is 24-bit, so 8 bits means the total number of bits will be 24 bits, and the total number of colors will be around 2 to the power 24, which will be around 16.7 million. So can you believe that there will be 16.7 million number of colors will be provided to you? But I don't know that how many of the colors you will use to create a picture, right? So that is what is the question is. So that means every pixel will take 3 bytes of memory. So similarly, if I give you an image of size, let's say 1000 cross 1000, fine. Let's say, let's say. Thousand cross thousand, it's a color image, fine. It's a color image, and it's a true color image. It's a color image, right? So now, who can say? So similarly, let me first complete what we are discussing in the last class, right? 24 bits was for color image, and similarly, 8-bit systems like grayscale images we are talking about. So how will you code a grayscale images grayscale image pixels using direct coding method is nothing but we all know that grayscale images basically 8-bit systems, and 8-bit systems we usually starts with, and it will be having definitely 256 colors, right? 256 colors, and the values will be 0 to 255. So look at the coding here, direct coding. So 0000 up to 8 zeros, and so on up to 8 ones. So this is nothing but the corresponding values and the corresponding color values. Maybe 0 stands for black, and 0 stands for black, and 255 stands for white. And then between gray colors and all of represents the values from 1 to 254. If the system is a 1-bit system, if the system is a black and white system, it is very easy to code the colors, because there will be definitely two different colors because it's a 1-bit system. And 0 where represents black and 1 represents white. Fine. So now my question is, if this question is given to you, or if an image is having size 1000 cross 1000, and it's a color image, if I'm using any direct coding method, so how much memory it is required, right? How much memory is required? And always, whenever we are talking about color, the two color image means it's a 24-bit standard we are using, right? 24-bit is a standard one, 24-bit. How much memory it will take? Yeah. So only one answer I could see in the chat box. What about others? Okay, so let me so what will be the memory size, I mean, required to store these images in bytes, let's say. Let us make it more precise, and in bytes mein kya hoga? Very simple. The total number of pixels, if you look at here, the total number of pixels are 10 to the power 3 into 10 to the power 6, whatever you can see, you can call it as 1 million as well. And multiply by how many bits, how many bytes required for one particular pixel. For one particular pixels, we require 24 bits, right? 8 bits for every primary component for RGB. And here it is nothing but 3 bytes. So the answers will be like 3 million bytes. So 3 million bytes is required. Fine. So although if you look at here, how many possible colors, how many choices are there for a 24-bit system, color system? We all know that 2 to the power 24 is a very big number. It is around 16 million. And here, maximum, how many colors you can use in this particular, who can say? Maximum, how many colors you can use in this particular image? Maximum. Maximum, how many colors? Yeah, Gaurav has written the answer. So 10 to the power 6. Yes, if all the pixels will be different only, then only we'll be having 10 to the power 6 number of colors, right? 10 to the power 6 number of colors. But in general, or in real time, we do not use like every pixels having different colors, that we all know, right? So the total number of colors possible is 2 to the power 24. However, here we are requiring 10 to the power 6. It is, I mean, it was around 16 point something millions colors possible, but we are not using that much of color, right? I mean, that much of color while using or while handling some true color images, right? But one thing, whatever, what we can see over here is it requires, actually it demands, right? It demands lot of memory space to store the images, right? So it requires a lot of, I mean, it is demanding high storage space when we talk about, basically when we talk about a 24 bit color system, right? So now we'll see something which is called as lookup table, right? Which is called as lookup table. And this lookup table will be helpful right now to reduce the memory requirement. We'll come to this example using lookup table, and what is lookup table, let us first discuss, and how it is helpful and how it is acting as a compromise between the desire to have a lower storage requirement and the need to support a reasonably sufficient number of simultaneous colors. We'll see what is this lookup table and when. So the number of bits, whatever we have seen right now, the number of bits per pixel, which is stored in the frame buffer, that we all know, right? To achieve the color, pixel color, to achieve the pixel color, required actually significantly storage space. I mean, required a high storage space, and this problem can be overcome if a storage space is introduced in between a frame buffer and a monitor. Basically, this lookup table is placed inside, or it's a part of the display controller. We'll also discuss later on. So actually where it is placed, so here it is called as, let's say, frame buffer. Store the pixel information, right? And finally we get the output on the monitor, right? And there is something called as a display control in between. Fine. Display controller, and inside this display controller there is something called lookup table. I'm representing it as a LUT. Fine. So that means, so we'll see what is this lookup table and how it stores the data, I mean, how it stores the colors, how it codes the colors, right? So as I mentioned that we are facing few problems using direct coding method. Basically, whenever we are talking about 24-bit system, we have seen how much memory it requires using direct coding system. So it's always better to find another solution which can reduce the storage requirement, right? And lookup table is one of the ways to handle this problem. And basically, it is a part of the display controller. And we'll see right now that how it is helpful. Fine. So in this approach, basically lookup table, this approach, the pixel values do not code the colors directly as we have seen here, 8 bit or 24 bit. It's not like that here. Rather, what it does is it points to some address or some indices of a table of color values, and that table is called as lookup table, right? So to make you understand that what is this lookup table and all, so let me quickly draw a figure and I'll show you that how a pixel value is pointed to the address of a particular table, and we'll see that how this address generated and how it is related to one pixel value, right? So let's say I'm having a pixel value. So generally, whenever we're talking about a pixel value, that is 8 bit, right? A pixel value at a position, at any position, pixel value. We do not know the color values, but in case of direct coding, we used to represent the same using 24 bit, because there itself we are deciding the color values, right? But here, as I mentioned, we will not code the colors directly like the direct coding method, right? So so what we will do is we will simply, as I mentioned, so we will point to a particular address in a table of color values. There will be one separate table which will contain the color values, and your job is to point this a particular pixel value or 8-bit pixel value to that address, and accordingly you will decide the color values. We'll see, okay, and with an example that how the memory space is reduced. Let's say any 8-bit pixel value, 8-bit pixel value. We have considered here, and the lookup table will look like this. If you look at the lookup table, the lookup table is very important. It will have different set of rows or addresses, you can say, and the addresses will be varies from. Right, so this is a lookup table as entries from 0 to 255. Okay, so these are what I've written in the left hand side of each row is nothing but called as address, starts with 0, ends with 255. And each of the entry here, it has three different parts. Fine. So one is for red, green, and blue. And we all know that this is nothing but a 24-bit. This is 24 bits. That means 8 bits per color, for each primary color. That we all know, right? 8 bits for each primary color. So then we'll see by considering one example. Let's say I'm taking one pixel value, and we all know we're talking about frame buffer, right? In frame buffer, the pixel values are, all the pixel informations are stored in binary format. We've talked about it. Let's say this is a pixel value converted to its corresponding 8-bit representation, and we want to find out the corresponding color of this particular one. And as I mentioned that here we do not have like systems like 24-bit systems to find out the color directly, because we do not want to use that method, as that method is having some problems. It always demands a high storage space. So what we want here is we want to find a relationship between this pixel value with this table, and then from that table we can decide the color values, right? So the pixel values right now, the pixel values what we're talking about are right now of 1 byte size or 8-bit, compared to the pixel values in the previous case is 3 bytes. You multiply 10 to the power 6 number of pixels multiply by 3 bytes, but here it is only 1 byte, right? So the pixel here is, comparatively, the pixel here is 1 byte or 8-bit quantities, you can say. Pixel here is 8-bit quantities. However, each entry of this lookup table is nothing but 24 bits, right? 24 bit. So the color of a pixel, let's say particularly this pixel, and maybe the corresponding value of this is, if I'm not wrong, it is 120. Can you please check it? The corresponding pixel values for this number, for this 8-bit quantities, I think is 120. Right, and it should lies between 0 to 255. That is why the addresses are from 0 to 255 here, because every one should point to one entry here of this table, right? Because it's an 8-bit one, and we all know the maximum value is 255 and the minimum value is 0. Fine, and here, if I'm not wrong, I think the value is 120. So then 120. So once you find out the value, right, the value which is nothing but 120 here, and the value lies between 0 to 255, and how will you find out the color values, right? How will you find out the corresponding color values? So now this one will be pointed to the 128th entries in the lookup table, which will be having three different quantities for R, G, and B, right? And accordingly, the color will be decided. Fine. So now, if we'll see, or if you want to calculate the storage space requirement for coding the colors, basically I'm talking about right here, right? Coding the colors. Let us consider the same example once again here. 1000 into 1000. So now, who can say that how much memory is required here? I mean, using this lookup table we are talking about, right? So how much storage requirement is there for particularly this is the same image, whatever we have talked about in case of direct coding. So we have talked about, so that here it is 10 to the power 6 multiplied by 3, right? So we have talked about, so this much bytes required in case of direct coding. So here who can say that how much memory or storage requirement is for this particular image having resolution 1000 cross 1000. See, very important to understand the concept that, as I mentioned, that we require only 1 byte of memory space or 8-bit quantities to represent one pixel, right? In addition to that, we also require some storage space requirement over here, right? We also require some storage space for each of the entry in the lookup table, fine. So now you tell me what will be the answer. And my next question is that how many simultaneous colors, because the combinations of RGB will ultimately give you one color. So how many simultaneous colors you can generate using this lookup table? And this lookup table is very easily changed, and it can be easily changed, right? So anytime it can be easily changed. So what I could see, several different types of answers in the chat box by Nitin, Bal Agarwal, by Astho Soni. But Astho Soni, your answer is very close answer. It's not correct, actually. You have made a mistake somewhere. Can you please check, Asutos, where we have done the mistake? So what I have told here is that we require 1 byte, because every pixel is of 1 byte. Right now, we are not representing every pixels in 24 bits. What we are doing is we are representing the pixel in 8-bit, but we are mapping these pixel values to a table values, to any of the entries of a table called a lookup table, which is responsible for finding out the colors, right? And that requires 24 bits for every entry of the table, for every entry, right? So then, particularly for this case, what I'm asking is, what will be the storage requirement given an image of size 1000 cross 1000? That's what. So Debal Grewal, so can you explain? So how have you written such answers? 1 million plus 256 into 3 whites. Debal, are you there?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Yes, sir.
Please explain your answer.
Sir, the term before the plus sign, sir, that is for the image. Sir, it has 1000 into 1000 pixel dimension and into 8 bits. So divided by 8 for the bytes. So
yes.
Total number of bytes for the image. And sir, the term after the plus sign, sir, that represents the memory for the lookup table.
Lookup table, very good. So that means how many entries are there? Entries. So what Asutos has written is 255. Asutos, it is not 255, it is 256. Why? Because the number of entries are 256. The maximum value is 255, but we have started with zero, right? We have started with zero, if you see, if we have started with zeros and every entries here requires 3 bits of memory. I mean, sorry, 3 bytes of memory, which is nothing but 24 bit. So the total memory requirement here will be 10 to the power 6 here. It is right, 10 to the power 6, I mean, 1 million bytes plus 3 bytes multiply by 256. So if you add up all this, I mean, it is will be around, I think, 768. And this is nothing but 1 million bytes plus 768 bytes. See, look at the size, 1 million plus 1,768 bytes. But in previous case, it was around 3 million bytes, right? 3 million bytes. So the size is drastically reduced here. That is fine. But how many colors? Now my question is, how many colors will you be able to generate by using this lookup table, whatever is given to you right now? How many colors are possible? How many colors are possible? Simultaneous colors. Yeah, it is only 256. Absolutely correct, all of you. Fine. So just remember one thing, that using this lookup table representation, an image is defined not only by its pixel values, but also by the color value in the corresponding lookup table. And these color values from a color map, those color values form a, basically these color values form a color map for the images, color map. Fine. And there are a few advantages using this lookup table, and there are a few disadvantages as well. What are the advantages of using this lookup table? We have discussed about the advantages, right? So this particular system provides, the system with this lookup table provides reasonable number of simultaneous colors without large frame buffers that we have seen, right? And the table entries, the one more important characteristics of this lookup table is the table entry can be changed easily based on the requirement. However, there are some disadvantages of using this lookup table. So what are those? This is nothing but the scan conversion is slow. Advantages we have already talked about, right? It provides a reasonable simultaneous number of colors without large frame buffers. The table entries can be changed anytime. And the disadvantages, if we talk about, the scan conversion conversion is slow. We have not yet discussed Kan conversion, right? So maybe after one, two classes, we'll start discussing scan conversion. How will you convert a continuous object into its corresponding discrete pixels or discrete objects, right? A setup for using setup pixels. We have not yet discussed. That becomes slow. And the refresh rate, 2 points here. The refresh rate of display decreases. Of display decreases here. Fine. So then there is again this problem should be handled, right? This problem should be handled. And now we are going to talk about a very interesting thing called as display processor. This is the last part our discussion. Then we'll start with directly the devices, display devices, and then we'll discuss the scan conversion and all, right? So just now we have seen that there are two disadvantages if you are using a lookup table-based system, that the scan conversion is low and the refresh rate of display decreases, right? So to avoid these problems, a separate graphics processor, a separate, you all know that, right? Today we're talking about something called as GPUs and all. To avoid these problems, a separate graphic processor is used that makes the main processor, the job of this type of processor, the display processor, or we call it as a graphics processor, the job of this is to make the main processor, right? The main CPU, the main processor, free from this graphics burden. Right, and that is what is called as a display processor. So that means there are two types of processor then we are talking about right now. One is the simple general purpose CPU, right, and one is a special purpose display processor, what we know. So this display processor may use peripherals that a simple processor use, that peripherals, right, and basically design for graphics operations, basically design for graphics operations. Fine. Then just a second. Okay. I'd like to draw a picture here just to show you that where this display processor is placed in a graphic system. Fine. So we have talked about the importance of the display processor, this graphics processor, basically used to handle the problems whatever we have seen just now. The scan conversion is slow. The refresh rate, if the refresh rate decreases continuously, so the display processor can handle the graphics related operations. Fine. So this is what is called as frame buffer. This is what we call as monitor, the whole graphics system we're talking about. And we have something called as display controller, if you remember the figure, whatever we have already drawn. Something called as display controller. And this display controller contains LUT. What do you mean by LUT here? Lookup table. And there is something called as display processor. Here, the placement of display processor. So here display controller with I mean this is the basically figure of the graphics system where the display controller is contains two different things. One is sorry, display controller contains two different things. One is display processor, as well as the lookup table. Fine. So these are the all prerequisites required to understand the contents, whatever is there in the rest of the contents, whatever is there in our course called as computer graphics. Right? So then we'll see the most important chapter called as video display devices. Mostly this is a pure theoretical part and you have to read by yourself most of the things. I should not discuss much about it. The video display devices, I will only discuss the concept behind this. All display devices, video display devices, fine. And few important things I will discuss, and the rest of the things you can read by yourself, but I'll give it as an assignment to you, right? So video display devices, okay? So typically the primary output device in any graphic system you talk about, so any graphic system, the primary output device is nothing but is a video monitor, right? Video monitor. And the operation of most of the video monitors we use in our country or across the globe are based on standard CRT design. CRT means cathode ray tube design. Video monitors. The common type of display devices is the video monitor. And it is all based on the operations of all these video monitors are based on CRT design. Cathode ray tube. I think you all might have seen the old televisions, old TVs, whatever we had in our home, and we have also seen the old computer systems, right? The old computer monitors, and in all those display systems. So CRT was the basic things, right? The concept of CRT was embedded. This cathode ray tube we'll discuss. But right now we are not using it, right? So right now what we are using is flat panel devices, LCD and LED, right? And the operations of LCD and the functions of LED and LCD is a bit different. But it is there to, it is actually important to understand the concept of this cathode ray tube and all, which were earlier used. Right now also people are using those televisions and as well as those monitors. People are using, still people are using, right? So we'll see that how this CRT basically, and what is the basic operations of a cathode ray tube, right? And how it is helpful in generating some pictures on the screen. And the basic principle behind all this cathode ray tube and all is nothing but it basically used to convert an electrical signal. And how we'll see how an electrical signal is being converted to a visual signal, we'll see. So basically, as I mentioned here, the electrical signal, as we're talking about something called as cathode, you better know, I think, what is cathode and what it contains and how the electrons, how they basically the the structure contains some electron gun, some cathode tube and all, it basically were used to generate or emit some set of electrons. And those set of electrons form some electron beam, and then it touches the phosphorus coated screen. We'll see with one, two examples and one figure also. So the basic principle here is to visual signal. And we'll see three different types of devices in CRT, three different type of devices which are based on the CRT design, we'll see, right? One is random scan display, raster scan display, we'll see, fine. Three different types of display which are based on this, what we call as CRT, right? So what are those three, as I mentioned? One is direct view, DVST. डायरेक्ट व्यू स्टोरेज क्यूब्स देन रेंडम स्कैन डिस्प्ले everywhere CRT is used and raster scan displays. Fine. We'll also see the principle of color CRT monitors. I'll try to cover all these things in the next class. Okay, and I'll give you some assignments here. You can read by yourself. And the concept we have already discussed. So this color CRT monitors can be of two types. One is, we'll see where beam penetration methods are used and where shadow mask methods are used, we'll see. These are all theoretical concepts, right? So we'll see all these things like direct view, storage tube, a little bit we'll discuss about it. And then first we'll talk about the principle and the operations of a CRT monitor, right? CRT based monitors and how these electron beams and how these electrons are emitted and pass through certain things. And then finally, we are getting some light in the screen that we'll see. Okay, and then we will discuss about different types of display devices based on the CRT, like DVST, random scan, and raster scan. Right, these are three, and this is the separate thing. This color monitor we'll see later on. Fine, okay. So, do you have another class right now? At 10 o'clock. Okay then, okay. So then what we have discussed today is the direct coding, some limitations of the direct coding. We have talked about the concept of lookup table, and also we have seen how the memory space is getting reduced by using this lookup table. And also we have seen what is a display processor and all. And then in the next class, as I mentioned, so we'll discuss much about this video display devices. And where we'll be talking about the CRT, the operations of a CRT monitor, and some display devices which are based on this, what is this called as the CRT design. Okay, so thank you all. Have a good day and see you in the next class.